So today in this video lecture, we will discuss another mode of a SIP register, and that is the PIPO SIP register. What is the full form of the PIPO? That is a parallel in, parallel out. Means our data will be entered in a parallel fashion and we read the data in a parallel fashion. So simultaneously all the 4 bits of the data will be transferred to a SIP register. Now how to load the data? Then again we have two different methods. One is known as a asynchronous method, asynchronous loading method, where without any clock pulses we can transfer our data to the SIP register. And another method is known as a synchronous method, or the synchronous loading. So in a synchronous loading, when we apply the clock pulse, then our input data will be stored in, simultaneously it will be stored into a SIP register. So here you can see that we have a 4-bit SIP register and all the flip-flops are connected to each other. Then here we applied, let us say we applied our input data x3, x2, x1 and x0. This is my flip-flop number 3, this is the flip-flop number 2, 1 and 0. Means we have a 4-bit SIP register. Now in an asynchronous loading, we use the input a preset as well as we use the clear. So this preset and the clear input are asynchronous control of a flip-flop, already we know. And with the help of this preset and clear, we can transfer our input data to the SIP register. So when we apply this preset as a high level and the clear as a low level, then this is going to be transferred into a SIP register x3, x2, x1 and x0. Or you can say we read this data as x3, x2, x1 and x0. So by applying this asynchronous control to the SIP register, we can transfer our input data to the SIP register like this. Now in a synchronous loading, we have to apply the clock pulse. So in an asynchronous loading, suppose our data are x3, x2, x1 and x0. When we apply this clock pulse, then the x3, x2, x1 and x0 are stored in a SIP register and we can read this in a parallel fashion. So this is known as a parallel in, parallel out SIP register. So in a asynchronous loading, we are using a preset and the clear input of the flip-flop. In a synchronous loading, we use only a clock pulse to transfer my 4-bit input data to the output. Now let us see what is the logic diagram for a asynchronous loading. Here one can see it is a 4-bit SIP register is there. So we use the 4 different flip-flop. This is a flip-flop number 3, flip-flop number 2, flip-flop number 1 and flip-flop number 0. We apply the clock pulse parallel to or simultaneously to all the flip-flops. Correct? And here whatever my input data are there, our input binary number is x3, x2, x1 and x0. It is applied to the preset input up the flip-flop through a kind of a NAND gate, and then we have a one control line which is known as a preset, or sometimes it is also known as a load. Either you can say the preset or the load. So this control line is used to enter the data. And the output. Output of this flip-flop is Y3, Y2, Y1 and Y0. So here you can say the input to the shift register is X3, X2, X1 and X0. And the outputs are a Y3, Y2, Y1 and Y0. Now, here we use a preset input. This preset input for loading the data. So, first of all, whenever we switch on the circuit, we have to clear out the shift register because we do not know what are the output of the flip-flop. Sometimes it can be 1 and 0. The random bits will be present in the output of the shift register. So, first of all, we have to clear the shift register. And for that, what we can do, that whatever my clear input is there, this is a clear input and it is a active low input. So, when we apply a clear input to 0, or we are connecting it to the ground, then the shift register is going to be reset. So, when we apply the clear a 0 or ground, then our Q3, Q2, Q1 and Q0 will be a 0. So, here you can say that this output will be 0, 0, 0 and 0, means we have reset the shift register. Correct? Now, we applied our a input data. Means, suppose we want to store the data like this, that x3, x2, x1, x0 is, let us say, it is a 1101. So, here 1 is present, here also 1 is present, 0 is there and x0 is 1. Now, in a preset, remember, in a preset, we know that when the preset is 0, because here it is a active low. Remember, here it is a active low. So, when the preset will be 0, then the flip-flop will be in a set condition. So, the Q will be equal to 1. And when the preset is going to be 1, then we have a normal operation. Normal operation. Or you can say that whatever the input is there, whatever the output is there, it will remain as it is. So here you have to remember, when the preset is 0, then your flip-flop is going to be in a set condition. Otherwise, if it is a 1, then it will remain in a previous state. Correct? So, here let us see that, let us say my load input is going to be a high, because here it is a active high. Correct? Now, if you look at this, a first NAND gate. 1-1 is the input for this NAND gate. Then the output of this NAND gate will be, when it is a 1-1, then the output of this NAND gate will be 0. So, here we have a 0 input. Then again, in a second case, this input is 1, then 1-1 input, so the output of this NAND gate is going to be 0. Now here, in a third NAND gate, this one of the input is 1, another input is 0, so this output of this NAND gate will be a 1. And again in the last one, if you see, then both the inputs are 1, so the output of this NAND gate is going to be 0. Now here I already explained that if the preset input is 0, then the flip-flop is going to be in a set condition. It will be in a set condition. So here if you see, the preset input is 0 and therefore this output will be a 1. In a second case, I'll say a preset input is 0, so this flip-flop is going to be in a set condition. Now here in a third flip-flop, the preset is high. So here whatever the data is present here, it is not going to change. It will be changed only when you apply the clock pulse or whatever the input is there, then it is going to change. But here we are not applying any input, so this output of the flip-flop will be remain 0. And here if you see the last NAND gate where the input or the preset is 0, and as a result this flip-flop is going to be in a set condition, so this will be 1. So here if you see that Y3 will be equal to 1, Y2 will be also equal to 1, Y1 is going to be 0, and this is also going to be 1. So here we can say that Y3, Y2, Y0 is 1, 1, 0, 1. So in this way, my input data is transferred into a SIP register. This whatever the input data is there, now it is transferred to this a SIP register. Here we apply this data parallelly, means simultaneously we apply the 4-bit binary number, and simultaneously we can read this data parallelly from this a SIP register, and therefore it is known as a parallel in parallel out SIP register. The advantage of this kind of the SIP register is there that you don't require any clock pulse, and without clock pulse you can transfer your data into the SIP register. So required time period is very small compared to the serial in serial out or the serial in parallel out SIP register. Now let us see what is the synchronous loading of a PIPO SIP register. Now you can see this logic diagram for the PIPO SIP register where we load the data simultaneously, or you can say it is a synchronous loading is there. Again we have a 4 different flip-flop, that flip-flop number 3, 2, 1 and 0. This inputs for the flip-flops are X3 that is connected to D3, X2 data is connected to D2, X1 is connected to D1 and X0 is connected to D0. And the output of the data is a Q3, that is a Y3, Q2 is connected to Y2, Q1 is connected to Y1 and the Q0 is connected to Y0. The second thing, that whatever the clear inputs are there, also they are connected to the VCC. And the preset inputs are there, it is also connected to a VCC. And as I already mentioned, that first of all, whenever we switch on, then we have to clear out the SIP register. So here, whatever the clear input is there, this clear input, you have to connect to the ground. So you can connect it to the ground initially. So the clear input will get 0, 0, 0, 0. And as a result, my output of the flip-flop is going to be also a 0, 0, 0. Means we have reset. We have to clear out the SIP register. And then you have to remove this ground. and apply a VCC. Apply the VCC. So this will be a 1, 1, 1. And here the preset. Preset is also connected to a plus VCC. So this will be a 1, 1, 1 and 1. And we know that in a flip-flop, when the preset is high and the clear input is high, then we have a normal operation of a flip-flop. Correct? Now you can see that the clock is applied simultaneously to all the flip-flop. So we have a common clock input. Parallelly, it is applied to the flip-flop. Let us say my input to this flip-flop or my X3, that input to the flip-flop is X3, X2, X1, X0. Let us say it is a 1010. 1, 0. This is my a 4-bit binary number. So X3 is 1, X2 is 0, X1 is 1, and X0 is also a 1. It means the D3 is also 1, D2 is 0, D1 is 1, and the D0 is 0. So these are the input to the flip-flop circuit. Now when we apply the clock pulse here, this clock pulse, and you can see we have a negative edge. This, all the flip-flop are going to be triggered with the negative edge. So when we apply this negative edge of the clock pulse, only one clock pulse, then due to this negative edge, here the negative edge is present. So in that case, what will happen? This, whatever the input data is there, it will be transferred to the output. So here, now the 1 is transferred to the output. You can see it is stored in the flip-flop number 3. In the second flip-flop, the input is 0. Then it will be transferred to the output, and it is also a 0 key. In a third flip-flop, the input is 1. With this negative A, here the Q1 will become a 1. And in a final flip-flop, the input is 0. So with the negative A, the output will be also become a 0. So here now you can see the Y3 is 1, Y2 is 0, Y1 is 1, and the Y0 is 0. So what is my output? So output is Y3, Y2, Y1, Y0. So after applying only one clock pulse, remember, after applying only one clock pulse, the outputs are a 1010. So here, in this way, by applying a clock pulse, whatever my input data are there, it is transferred to the shift register, and here you can read this data in a parallel fashion. So we apply this data in a parallel fashion and we read this data in a parallel fashion. So it is a parallel in, parallel out shift register. I already mentioned what is the advantage, that in a serial in, serial out, serial in, parallel out, we require minimum 4 clock pulse to enter the data. And to read this data, you require another 4 clock pulse. So the time period is almost a 7 to 8 clock cycles are there. Here in a PIPO shift register, you require only one clock pulse to enter the data or to store the data into a shift register.